Good morning, students. So in the last class, we have started chapter 11, construction, and I have completed question number 1. I hope all of you understood. I already told you that this chapter is difficult for me to teach through online mode. But I am trying my best. I hope all of you understood question number 1. In case any doubt, you can ask me anytime. And this chapter, always you remember, you need to know how to construct, because you cannot copy. Okay, you need to know how to construct. So today I am going to solve question number 2 and 3 from exercise 11.1. Question number 2, construct a triangle of size 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm and then a triangle similar to it whose sides are 2 by 3 of the corresponding size of the first triangle. Give the justification of the construction. See, here in the first part, you have to construct a triangle. Means construct a triangle of size 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm. In the second case, you need to construct another triangle, means similar triangle, whose sides are 2 by 3 of the corresponding side of the first triangle, and give the justification of the construction. Okay. Try to understand. First of all, we have to know the sides. The sides are given 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm. First, I am using my pen to get clarity, but I request all of you, please don't use pen. Okay, so first we will draw a line segment of 4 cm. Suppose this is B and this one is C. Now there are two sides again, 5 cm and 6 cm. You can see the question. So using your compass, take 5 cm, all of you know this, how to take this one, 5 cm, and B as center, draw an arc. Okay? Now, the next side is 6 cm, take 6 cm using your compass and skull. Then, C as center, draw another arc, and you should see that the arcs intersect at a point. See, they intersect. This is the point. Yes, this one and this one is the arc. Now join this. Means suppose this name of this point is A, then join AC. And AB. Just for your understanding, I am giving like this. Don't give like this, okay? Because when I use pen, it is not clear. These are darks, okay? Clear? Now, in the question, it is given that after constructing this triangle, we have done the first part. Now, in the second case, it is given that you have to construct one more triangle similar to this triangle whose sides are 2 by 3 of the corresponding sides. See the denominator. In the denominator, you have how much? 3. So, draw a ray making equiangle with B. And take 3 equal parts. You can take 2 cm for each part, or you can take 1 cm for each part. I am taking 1 cm. This is B1, B2, and this is B3. Clear? Okay. Now, join B3C. Try, listen, why I'm joining B3C? Because the denominator is 3 here. Yes or no? So join B3C. Maybe you are getting confusion that how many parts we need to take. I have taken 3 parts. So why should we take 3 parts? Because the fraction is 2 by 3. See, you have to see the fraction first and you need to find out the which is the bigger number. This is a conception that the bigger number is 3. This is shortcut conception you can do easily or you can construct easily. The bigger number is 3. You have to find out which is the bigger number. Either denominator is bigger or numerator is bigger, that is not a problem, but which is the bigger number? 3 is bigger number here. That is why I have taken 3 parts. Now I have joined B3C. This is because the denominator is 3. Okay? Means need to take parts according to the bigger number and need to join according to the denominator. Okay? Clear? Now draw a parallel line through B2, which is parallel to B3C. Which you need to draw a line parallel to B3C through B2. So yesterday I have taught you how to draw parallel line. For this, you have to draw an arc with any radius. Suppose B2 is center, I am drawing an arc. Okay, this is the arc. Now with the same measurement as B3 is center, I draw another arc. Okay, is it clear to you? Okay, now find this measurement, not from B2, okay, this arc, what is intersect on this ray, this measurement, okay, then take from here and cut here. Okay, now join through this point from B2 to this point. See, you are getting an exact parallel line here. Yes. Now suppose this one is B dash. Or you can write C dash also, no problem. You can give any name. So I am giving C dash because I have already B1, B2 I have given. That is why I have given C dash. Okay. This is C dash. Now draw a line parallel to AC through C dash. Okay. Similar steps or same steps you can use. Draw an arc. Pass. A center C dash with any measurement, with same measurement C as center, draw another arc. Okay, now you have to take this measurement, this one, and cut here. Now throw this point, join this line. Okay, this is suppose AS. So first triangle you got ABC and a similar triangle with size are 2 by 3 of the corresponding size of the first triangle, that is AS B and AS B C S. So this is the construction. So you can give the name of the ray, suppose this is BX. Okay, now need to write steps and justification. Okay. next. So it is completed. Now justification. You can see we have BC dash by C dash C. See this figure, BC dash how many parts? 2 parts, and C dash C 1 part. So you can write 2 by 1, this is 2 by 1. Then therefore BC by BC dash, BC by BC dash, these are the corresponding sides. In BC you can write BC dash plus C dash C, BC dash plus C dash C by BC dash. Now if we split this one or break, then BC dash by BC dash plus C dash C by BC dash, BC dash BC dash, BC dash cancel 1, then C dash C by BC dash, already we have BC dash by C dash C 2 by 1, so C dash C by BC dash is 1 by 2. So 2 plus 1 by 2, what we got the result? 3 by 2. Means BC by BC dash we got 3 by 2. So BC dash by BC is equal to what? 2 by 3. BC dash is the correspondence of the side of the, means BC dash is the side of the second triangle and BC is the side of the first triangle. So we got this ratio is 2 by 3. Since triangle A dash B, A dash B C dash and ABC similar. Why? Because see, these lines are parallel, then these are alternate angles. And this is the common angle for both the triangle. So using AA, we can say that triangle A dash B C dash similar to triangle ABC. So the corresponding sides are in the same ratio. So you can write A dash B by AB, BC dash by BC is equal to A dash C dash by AC. So what do you got? BC dash by BC 2 by 3. Since this is equal to this 2 also, that is why older ratio is equal to 2 by 3. So you justified this one. Now steps. So how do we have done? Already I told you in the last class that steps you need to write by yourself. So what I have done, first we have constructed a triangle ABC, that is I have written construct triangle ABC of sides AB is equal to 5 cm, this AB, BC is equal to 4 cm and AC is equal to 6 cm. Now making equidangle with B, draw a ray BX and take 3 equal parts BB1 is equal to B1, B2 is equal to B2, B3. I have not written this one. If you want to write, you can write. Just I have written like this. Making equidangle with B, draw a ray BX and take 3 equal parts. I hope all of you understood. Join B3C and draw a line parallel to B3C through B2 whose intersect BC at C dash. See. Draw a line, join B3C and draw a line parallel to B3C through B2 whose intersect BC at C dash. After that, what we have done? We have repeated the same thing again here. Draw a line parallel to CA through C dash whose intersect AB at A dash. That is why I have written shortcut. Similarly, we get A dash C dash similar to AC. Or come parallel to AC. Okay. So that means we got the, at last we got triangle A dash B C dash. Therefore, A dash B C dash is the required triangle. Okay. This much only. Understood? Okay. Next. Now question number 3, construct a triangle with sides 5 cm, 6 cm and 7 cm and then another triangle whose sides are 7 by 5 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle, give the justification of the construct. Maybe you are thinking that this is a similar question, but little different this is. You can see the fraction, what you got in question number 2, the denominator is greater than the numerator, but here you can see the denominator is less than the numerator. In this case, how you will construct? For this, similar steps or same step you have to follow. See, first of all, you have to draw a line segment. Five centimeters. Okay. Now, the other two sides are 6 cm and 7 cm. Suppose this is B, C. Using your scale and compass, take 6 cm and BS center, draw an arc. Now, the next side is 7 cm. Using your scale and compass, take 7 cm and CS center cut the previous arc. This point, suppose this is A. Now join this. AC, BC. So this is the first part you have completed. Now you have to draw another triangle whose sides are 7 by 5 of the corresponding size of the first triangle. For this, you have to follow the similar steps. Draw a ray making equidangle B. Now see the fraction. 7 by 5. What is the bigger number? 7. So take 7 equal parts from this line. Okay. B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7. Clear? Now you need to see that fraction again. What is the denominator? 5. So you have to join B5C. Clear? Now you can see these two points, B6 and B7. Now you have to draw a line parallel to B5C through B7. For this, you have to extend BCS ray . Okay, now you know how to draw a parallel line. Draw an arc of any radius, B7 is center, with the same measurement, draw another arc, B5 is center, now take this measurement. From this and where it will intersect at, what it is intersect at, BC, and cut this from this point. Okay, now join this. Now see, you got a parallel line. Clear? And this is suppose C this. Now extend BAS ray and draw a line parallel to AC through CS. This is CS. So for this, already I told you what to do, how to draw a parallel line. Draw an arc, then same measurement, draw an arc, CS center, first CS center, then CS center. Now cut this length. Okay, now join this. So this is suppose AS. Okay. So this is the figure. ABC is the first triangle, then A dash B this B, C dash is the second triangle. So I hope all of you understood. In case any doubt, you can ask me. Now you need to know the steps of construction and justification. So we have completed this one, question number 3 now. The construction and justification. See, in this triangle, you can see triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADSBCDS. Already I have said in question number 2, the using A, this corresponding angle, this is the common angle, Using A, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. If they are congruent, then their corresponding sides are in the same ratio, AB by AD B, BC by BC dash, AC by AD C dash. But BC by BC dash, you can see BC by BC dash. BC how many part? 5. And BC dash how many part? 7. So we can write what? 5 by 7. Okay. If you write like this, BC by BC, then if BC by BC is 5 by 7, then BC dash by BC is 7 by 5. So you got BC by BC is 7 by 5. Now, if triangle ADSBC is similar to triangle ABC, then their corresponding sides are in the same ratio. ADSB by AB, BC by BC is equal to ADSC by AC. Since we got BC BC is equal to 7 by 5, so this older ratio is equal to 7 by 5. Clear? Justification. So I know all of you understood the justification. First of all, what we have done? Construct triangle ABC of sides AB 6 cm. BC is equal to 5 cm and AC is equal to 7 cm. Now making equidangle with B, draw a ray BX, then take 7 equal parts because 7 is greater here. Then join, I forgot to write, join B5C and draw a line parallel to B5C, throw B7. And you need to produce BC SRA. And that is why I have written here. Join B5C and draw a line parallel to B5C. Throw B7 whose intersect BC produced at C dash. So similarly, we get this one also. If you draw a line parallel to CA, throw C dash. It will intersect BA produced at this A, BA produced at A dash. Therefore, you got a required triangle A dash B C dash. Okay, in this two triangle, question number 2, have got that denominator is greater than the numerator. And there you can see the triangle, second triangle is inside the first triangle. Yes, and when the denominator is less than the numerator, you can see the second triangle means required triangle is greater, is means the first triangle is inside the second triangle. Okay, so I hope all of you understood. So in case any doubt, please ask me, okay? So as your positive confidence, or to get your positive confidence, please try as homework question number 4. Okay, homework is, sorry, 4. Yes, okay, question number 4 here is your homework. Okay, thank you.